ورود الفاقات أعياد المريدين. You know, we're coming to Eid. And what is real Eid in other means, other words? Real Eid, and as one of the poets said, is the day that Allah forgives you and accepts you. That's the real Eid. There's no happiness without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah has accepted you and has forgiven you, you have Eid every day. And he says here, the real Eid, the coming of the real Eid for the mureedeen, the seekers, the novices, is the when the states of need arrive, burudul faqat. And what does this mean? The days that we have to go through difficulties, through trials, through these, you know, calamities, fitan, you know, trials and difficulties, are the ones that remind us of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they should really be the moments of joy. If you're remembering Allah, that's in itself a moment of joy. Calling upon Allah is a moment of joy, is a moment of goodness. And we should therefore be joyful and happy that we have been allowed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to call upon Him. He has blessed our tongues and our hearts to turn to Him and call upon Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we realize our weakness and our neediness to Him. It's the time of celebration. It's the feast days here, translation of Eid. The Ayyad, the Eids really for us are when we realize our state of need. So when the difficulties come, we should really take joy from this. And then the next hikmah he says, sometimes you will find more benefit in states of need than in your ritual fasting and in your prayer. رُبَّمَا وَجَدْتَ مِنَ الْمَزِيدِ فِي الْفَاقَاتِ. It might be that you found in more and more states of dire need and difficulties. مَا لَا تَجِدُهُ فِي الصَّلَاةِ فِي الصَّوْمِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. That you will not find, that you may not find in the fasting that we're doing in Ramadan, the salahs that we pray and, you know, we stand and submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? What's so special about these difficult times? How could they be better than prayers? Because when we fast, when we pray, we are almost like we're presenting our strength to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, presenting what we have to give to Him. Whereas when He brings on the difficulty for us, and He's the one that tests us with these, you know, circumstances, then it's from Him Almighty. He wants you to turn to Him within that. When you find that moment of submission to Allah within your difficulty, it's something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes that much more pure-hearted, that much more free of any claims, free of any showing off riya. Whereas in our fasting, in our prayer, we can feel that somewhat. Sometimes we even show it to others, you know. So this is, there's no, what they say, hadd an-nafs. There's no portion for the self or joy for the self or share of goodness or, you know, some kind of happiness for the self when it comes to the difficulties and the hardships. It's a complete state of submission, which you will may find that to bring you closer to Allah more than prayer and fasting could. So this is one of the wisdoms where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put us through difficulties. And then he states in the next hikmah, al-faqatu busutul mawahib. The states of need, these faqat, these indigence that we have, are gift-laden carpets, busutul mawahib, rugs basically, that you spread out, that are full of mawahib, of gifts. So when we have these times of difficulty, we see that we're with Allah. The gift is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala us coming closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Him bringing us closer to Him. He's bringing us closer by these rugs laid out. You know, these bisat is like almost like an analogy to how you lay out the red carpet and, you know, the nice kind of spread for those who you want to entertain, who you want to be hospitable to and kind to. So Allah is not wanting us to suffer through the difficulties. He's trying to bring us closer to Him, to see the gifts He has in store for us, to see the blessings He has in store for us. These, what they call the nafahatul rahmaniyah, right? The Prophet ﷺ said, surely Allah has nafahat, these breezes, these blessings. Alat fata'arradu laha. Then expose yourselves, you know, go towards these nafahat, these breezes of blessings, of rahmah, of mercy, of kindness, of goodness. Ramadan in itself is a massive nafhatun min nafahati ar-Rahman. You know, it's one of the great, greatest blessings and gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us from all of His gifts, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This blessed month of Ramadan, the greatest of all months. Had the Muslims known the true value of this month, they would have wished, as the Prophet said, all months to be Ramadan al-Kareem, alhamdulillah.